Hello everyone, I'm Professor Nirav Mehta from LG Institute of Technology and Engineering. I'm welcoming to you my session for designing of helical gate. Today we are going to discuss about case study of helical gate. So previously we have discussed about case study of a spur gate, in which we have taken different example in different equation and calculation and made calculation for the spur gate. You can call it as an example in your, for your GDU syllabus. So let's discuss more about this helical gear. Helical gear is a different from spur gear in terms of its geometrical consideration. So what will going to be a different here? It will be your equivalent number of teeth, because in case of helical gear, teeth make angle with its own gear axis, and this angle is called helix angle. So our equivalent number of gear will going to be different depending on the angle made by its teeth with its own axis. Clear? So let's get into this example. So this is example. A pair of helical gear are transmitting power of 15 kilowatts. So we are transmitting power of 15 kilowatt. Clear? So, and so we are transmitting power of 15 kilowatt. So power is 15 kilowatt, and this teeth system, which is 20 degree stub angle with diameter plan, having helix angle which is alpha, which is 45. What is difference between this angle, which is 20, and 45? This 20 angle is made by a teeth which is own axis, clear, vertically, and which is called teeth angle. Clear? And this alpha is angle made by parallelly, which is called helix angle. Clear? So that is the basic difference between teeth angle and helix angle. Clear? And pinion it runs at 10,000 rpm, and it has 80 mm pitch diameter. So diameter, which is dp, is 80 mm. The gear has 320, so diameter of gear is 320 mm. If the gears are made of cast steel, so here both the gears, pinion and gear, clear, driver and driven, both are of the same material. So allowable static stress for pinion will be equal to allowable static stress for gear, and which is 100 megapascal. Clear? Which is 100 megapascal. Determine the suitable module and face width if it is as a, and check it for wear. So here we are provided sigma es, which is endurance limit, 618 megapascal. All we have to find is module M and face width B. Here for standard gear, relationship between module and this face width is always in between 10, like this, B always in between 10 of the module to 14 of the module. So here we will take it as a 12.5 of the module. So relationship between module and this face width for this particular example is 12.5 of the module. Now all we have to find is this module, but we don't know, we don't have our WT, and which is called thrust load. Clear? Because WT will going to give us this face width and module. What is WT? Sigma 0 into CS into B into pi M into, here it will be Y dash. And here you can see sigma P and sigma G will be the same, sorry, sigma P and sigma B will be same. It's not mm, it is megapascal. So it is 100 megapascal. So our Y, or you can say multiplication of Y with sigma P and sigma G, it is going to depend on number of teeth on your gear and pinion. So here let's establish one rule. When pinion and gear are having the same material, then we are going to design it for pinion only. So it will always going to be yp dash, and this will going to be sigma p. Clear? So here in this case, when the material of pinion and gear is same, we are going to design them for a same or for a pinion only. Clear? But we don't have here we have sigma p. We can find cs depending on velocity. We have to find this b, m, and yp, which is depending on tp, wt. We have to find. So let's find, first of all, let's find wt. Now, how to find this wt here? We can find this wt depending on our transmission of power. How? Because transmission of power is nothing but our velocity. Yeah, sorry, we will give you a torque. Now, let's discuss about relationship between power and torque. So you know that torque is equals to 2 pi n t by 60, that is power. So torque will be power into 60 divided by 2 pi n. Clear? So all we have is this power into, so we can find this torque. Now, how we are going to find wt depending on this torque? So wt is a force. So force is nothing but torque. Clear? Sorry. Torque is nothing but force into radius. In our case, force is wt and radius is dp by 2. So to find this wt, we have to find torque. So torque is 2t divided by dp. Clear? So first of all, we have to find torque. Torque, here we have this power. Power is 15 kilowatts. So 15 into 10 raised to 3 into 60 divided by 2 into 3.14 into 10,000. So here our torque in terms of, here we are going to consider in terms of Newton into meter. So it is 14.32 Newton into meter. So our torque will going to be 14.32 Newton into meter. Clear? So depending on that, we can find this wt. Now to find this wt here, this is in Newton into meter, and dp is in mm. So I have to convert either this torque into Newton into mm or dp into that meter. So we are converting this torque into Newton into meter. So convert this Newton into meter, we have to multiply it by 10 raised to 3. So 14.32 divided by 10 raised to 3 divided by dp, which is 80 mm. So ultimately we can find it as a 358 newtons. So our load which is acting on this will going to be 358 newton. Clear? So you are clear how you are going to find wt. So wt is directly find depending on this torque. How we have find this torque depending on this power. Why we are about to find torque? Because we have to find this wt. Now depending on this wt, we have to find our module and phase width. Before getting into this module and phase width, we have to find velocity. Clear? Velocity of this gear. So velocity, to find this velocity, because velocity will give us CV. Clear? Which is service vector depending on its velocity. The velocity is nothing but 2 pi dp np divided by 60. So we have this velocity, which is pi dp np by 60, 3.14 into 80 into 1000 divided by 60, so which is 42 meter per second. So if we found this velocity 42 meter per second, so our equation for velocity factor will be 0.75 divided by, because it is way higher than 20 meter per second. So all we have to find is CV, which is depending on this, and it is given in our even design data book, as well as we have discussed about that. When velocity is greater than 20 meter per second, it is 0.75 divided by 0.75 plus under root V, which is 42. ultimately we will find it as a value which is depending on this velocity. Clear? Okay, so our velocity will ultimately will be depending on this value 0.104. So our CV is nothing but 0.10. Clear? Okay, so let's move on to next point. Our next point is to find YP and how we are going to establish the relationship of YP. Clear? As well as all we have to find is this sigma P. So now for a YP dash, we have equation for YP dash 0.175 minus 0.841 divided by TEP is nothing but equivalent number of T. So first of all, we have to find equivalent number of T in P. So TEP is equals to TP upon cos cube alpha, which we have discussed previously to find out this equivalent number of teeth. So TP, we don't have TP, so DP divided by module is nothing but TP cos cube alpha. So ultimately DP divided by M cos cube alpha, DP is 80 divided by M cos cube 45 degree. So ultimately TEP will be come out it as a 226.4 divided by module. Let's put this value into this YP dash. So 0.175 minus 0.841 divided by 226.4 into M. So ultimately it will represent it by this 0.175 minus 0.0037 of module. So YP dash, it come out it as a YP dash is come out it as a 0.175 minus 0.0037 of module. So this is your YP. Now we will put all these values in our WT. So let's find out our WT depending on this. This, so WT will be sigma P into CV into B into pi M into YP dash. So WT we have found out is 358 is equals to sigma B, which is 100, CV 0.104 into B in terms of module, so 12.5 into 3.14 into module, sorry, 12.5 module into the bracket 0.175 minus 0.0037 of module. So by simplifying this equation, we have found module which is equals to 2.8 mm. Clear? Or you can say it is around, sorry, we have found out is 2.3 mm, which is almost equal to 2.5 mm. So module will going to be a 2.5 mm. So depending on that, P will be 12.5 into 2.5 mm, which is almost equal to 32 mm. So we have found out module and face width of our gear. So here we are ended with our first portion, which is to find out module and this face width. Now in next session or next part of this session, we are going to find wear load capacity of our gear. I hope you understand this design equation or design session very well to find out this module and face width. In next portion of this or part of this, we are going to find our wear load of this module. Thank you. Thank you so much.